Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Lebrick. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received at Safriya Palace the President of the United Nations General Assembly, the UNGA, Miroslav Lajax, who is in the kingdom to take part in the Work Entrepreneurs Investment Forum of 2017. His Majesty welcomed the guests and his accompanying delegation, highlighting his participation in the forum and hailing the advanced level of coordination and cooperation between Bahrain and the UNGA in the fields of achieving sustainable development goals, supporting entrepreneurship, and enhancing economic and investment growth. His Majesty affirmed that Bahrain's human resources and competencies and the infrastructure and encouraging environment it provides for entrepreneurs and investors made the kingdom a favorite destination for entrepreneurs and international companies of various fields. He noted the kingdom's achievements in the field of connecting sustainable development goals with entrepreneurship and creativity, which made Bahrain a world model, commending the role of Bahraini women and their contribution to the development in the kingdom. His Majesty the King stated that the kingdom welcomes all the participants in the World Entrepreneurs Investment Forum 2017, affirming that Bahrain's keenness to provide an attractive economic environment that works as part of an advanced legislative system. He emphasized the importance of the United Nations' role in strengthening regional and international security, peace and stability, and in finding solutions for various world problems, wishing the UNGA president success in his duty. For his part, the UNGA president praised the investment and economic vision in the kingdom, its pioneering role in the region, and the historic role of Bahraini women and their participation and achievements in various developmental, political, economic, and social aspects in Bahrain. Deputy Prime Minister Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa received United Nations General Assembly President Miroslav Lajak on the occasion of his participation in the World Entrepreneurs Investment Forum 2017, hosted in the Kingdom of Bahrain under the patronage of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa. Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak affirmed the UNGA's role in supporting collective international work, praising the ongoing cooperation between the United Nations Industrial Development Organization, the UNIDO, and the Kingdom of Bahrain in boosting the small and medium-sized enterprises' contribution to achieve sustainable development goals. President of the UNGA thanked the Deputy Premier for his welcoming reception, expressing his delight to participate in the World Forum, praising the advanced level of cooperation between Bahrain and the United Nations. The Deputy Prime Minister Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa received today at Ghudaybiyah Palace the President of the United Nations General Assembly, the UNGA, Miroslav Lajak, who is in the kingdom to take part in the World Entrepreneurs Investment Forum 2017. Held under the patronage of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, in the presence of the Minister of Foreign Affairs Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa, the Minister of Industry and Commerce and Tourism Zayed bin Rashid Zayani, and a number of worldwide entrepreneurs who expressed thanks and appreciation to His Royal Highness the Prime Minister for patronizing the forum. The Deputy Prime Minister affirmed Bahrain's commitment to the Sustainable Development Goals of 2030. The Deputy Prime Minister conveyed the greetings of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister to the UNGA President and the participants in the forum, wishing them a pleasant stay in the kingdom. He stated that the kingdom's holding of the World Forum reflects the keenness of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and the government headed by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, and the support of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa for patronizing every international activity that will contribute to achieving the Sustainable Development Goals. He added that the government work programs of 2015-2018 and the plans and national strategies were designed to conform to the Sustainable Development Goals of 2030. For his part, the UNGA president and entrepreneurs expressed thanks and appreciation to the kingdom for its keenness on international activities and events that aim to achieve sustainable development, noting that His Royal Highness's patronization of the forum has a profound impact on its success and attraction of over 1,000 participants. Deputy Prime Minister Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa patronized the 10th annual ceremony of Sheikh Mohammed bin Abdullah Al Khalifa Award for Scientific Research for 2016. The ceremony was organized by King Hamad University Hospital's Bahrain Medical Magazine and was attended by the Chairman of the Supreme Health Council, Lieutenant General Sheikh Dr. Mohammed bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, the Minister of Health, Faiq bin Saeed Al Saleh, and the Commander of the King Hamad University Hospital, Major General Dr. Sheikh Salman bin Atiyatullah Al Khalifa, and a number of senior officials. Deputy Premier Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah called on health, educational, and specialized institutions to intensify their efforts in conducting medical researches to match the development of this vital sector, which is considered one of the main pillars for human development, and to meet the goals of the National Strategy for Scientific Research between 2014 to 2024. He also called to circulate the findings and recommendations of researchers by sharing them in international scientific journals. Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah praised the award as one of the leading initiatives in the fields of science and health, adding that it has contributed to reinforcing the importance of local scientific research. He added that the directives of the leadership and the support of the government, along with national medical cadres, have contributed to improving the quality of the health system in Bahrain. He noted the efforts of the chairman of the Supreme Council for Health, evident in the new health insurance system to be launched after the end of the current legislative term. During the ceremony, Lieutenant General Sheikh Dr. Mohammed bin Abdullah Al Khalifa delivered a speech in which he affirmed the importance of medical researches. He added that Bahrain has witnessed in the previous four decades in the field of medical services. He expressed pride in Bahraini cadres, national universities, and specialized educational institutions. Sheikh Mohammed bin Abdullah then honored and congratulated the winners of the award, whose topics covered a wide range of topics, including sickle cell disease, diabetes, and different types of cancer. On behalf of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, Deputy Prime Minister Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa inaugurated the second edition of the Gulf Congress of Clinical Microbiology and Infectious Diseases, the GCC-MID 2017, organized by Bahrain Medical Society in cooperation with the Saudi Society for Medical Microbiology and Infectious Diseases and the Emirates Medical Association for Infectious Diseases. The conference is held at the Gulf Hotel until the 4th of November in the presence of the Speaker of the Representatives Council, Ahmed Al-Mulla, senior officials and guests. Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah expressed thanks and appreciation to His Royal Highness the Prime Minister for delegating him to open the conference. He added that the wise leadership of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and the role of the government led by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa and the continuous support of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa provided a special attention to the health sector and its cadres. He also said that the government is committed to implementing program development, health services, and ensure the best use of resources in order to provide high-quality and sustainable health services. Deputy Prime Minister expressed confidence that this conference will help enhance the skills of doctors, provide the most recent medical information and disease control. He welcomed all of the conference participants and expressed appreciation to Bahrain Medical Society for organizing the event, which reflects the progress of the field in the kingdom. A number of speakers delivered speeches expressing their thanks and appreciation to His Royal Highness the Prime Minister for patronizing the event and to the WISE leadership for their keenness to develop the medical sector. Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah then honored senior guests and sponsors and also toured the exhibition that showcased modern medical products and services. The Education Minister, Dr. Majid bin Ali al-Naimi, has delivered Bahrain's speech during the 39th United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, the UNESCO General Assembly, in the French capital, Paris. The minister congratulated Zuhour Alaoui on the obtaining the trust of the General Assembly. He also conveyed the congratulations of the leadership to the new General Director, Audrey Azoulay. The minister expressed the kingdom's appreciation of the tremendous efforts exerted by the UNESCO's general director, Irina Bokova, during her tenure at the helm of the UNESCO, citing the numerous achievements during her directorship. The minister expressed the kingdom's support of UNESCO's vision beyond 2015 and exerting all efforts to implement the UNESCO-proclaimed Sustainable Development Goals, the SDGs, commending the UNESCO's two-year budget and ambitious projects to provide education for all as part of the UNESCO Strategy 2030 and to benefit from science and technology as it befits the need of humankind. On this occasion, the minister hailed the civilizational initiative of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa in establishing the King Hamad Center for Interfaith Dialogue and Peaceful Coexistence in Los Angeles, USA, for its vital role in consolidating the principles of community coexistence among the people to tackle all attempts at segregation among the human communities. His Majesty initiative is compatible with the UNESCO's goal of boosting tolerance, dialogue, and peace. The minister cited the aspects of ongoing cooperation between the Kingdom of Bahrain and UNESCO, especially the announcement of the UNESCO King Hamad ICT in Education Award that has been serving the UNESCO's goals since 2006. Under the strategy of the Ministry of Transportation and Telecommunication on the development of the national cadres in the field of air surveillance, Minister Engineer Kamal bin Ahmed Mohammed and Timkeen CEO Dr. Ibrahim Janahi signed an agreement to launch a Ajwa program. The minister expressed thanks and appreciation to His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander, and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa for supporting and his directives to especially with the project related to air transport and initiatives aiming to develop Bahraini human capital and create job opportunities. He also thanked Timkeen for their cooperation to launch this program, which gives 21 Bahrainis the opportunity to obtain certificates in the fields of engineering and navigation. The Deputy Chairman of the Board of Trustees and Executive Director of Isa Cultural Center, Sheikh Khalid bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, affirmed that the initiatives of the Declaration of the Kingdom of Bahrain and launching Hamad Global Center for Interfaith Dialogue and Peaceful Coexistence enhances the status of the people of Bahrain as ambassadors of religious tolerance and peaceful coexistence to the world. He reviewed the most prominent features of the history of coexistence and religious and sectarian diversity in Bahrain and the historical contributions of the leadership and people, which paved the way for all cultural achievements in the kingdom. He added that His Majesty the King's Reform Project and the National Action Charter affirmed the kingdom's guarantee of religious and personal freedoms and the freedom of expression and equality between citizens. He added that His Majesty the King has also supported religious and peaceful tolerance through various initiatives since 2001 until today. He asserted that the initiative of establishing Hamad Global Center makes the kingdom a global center for important meetings, dialogues, and conferences related to achieving peace between religions and eliminating terrorism and extremism among the youth. Bahrain's permanent representative to the United Nations office in Geneva, Ambassador Dr. Youssef Abdel Karim Boucheri, has said that the kingdom rejects the statements made by Qatar's permanent representative to the UN and considers them a violation of its sovereignty and a blatant interference in its internal affairs. He stressed that the Kingdom of Bahrain has the right to take any decision and procedure it deems necessary to preserve its national security, especially towards a country that has consistently conspired against it, seeking to destabilize it and undermine its security. Dr. Boucheri added that the decision to impose entry visas, whether on Qatari citizens or residents or other nationalities, is a national and sovereign right and is based on the provisions of the Constitution and national laws and is in accordance with the principles and rules of international law. He also asserted that Bahrain has not violated any resolutions of the international conventions or treaties in this regard. He concluded by saying that the kingdom is one of the most affected countries in the region by Qatar's policies, which did not respect neighborliness nor the ties between the two brotherly people. He stated that the Qatari regime had tried to destabilize the security and stability of Bahrain through spreading chaos and terrorist acts that the kingdom still suffers from and tries to combat in light of its international role in the fight against terrorism, especially that it is a founding member of the International Coalition to Fight Terrorism. Advocate General Chancellor Ahmed Al-Hammadi said that suspects Ali Salman had been summoned and questioned over charges of exchanging intelligence information with a foreign country and with those serving its interests to carry out hostile acts against Bahrain, as well as to harm its military, political, and economic standing and undermine its national interests. The suspect was also quizzed about delivering and divulging defense secrets to a foreign country, disseminating a tendentious news and statement about the internal situation in Bahrain for the sake of undermining its prestige and status. The public prosecution remanded him in custody pending further investigation into the case, and the sentence will be served after he completes his current jail term in the case in which he was convicted. The Advocate General asserted that the public prosecution had carried out investigations into the telephone conversations held between both Ali Salman and Hassan Sultan with Qatari officials and the agreement and coordination between the two sides to carry out hostile acts in Bahrain to damage its military, political, economic, and national interests, as well as to undermine its prestige and status abroad. Al-Hammadi said that investigations revealed that validity of those events and proved that Qatar had engaged in activities targeting many Arab countries, particularly Bahrain. He further explained that Doha had, since 2010, mobilized its media to attack the ruling regime in Bahrain and contact some elements, including Ali Salman and others, for this purpose. The Advocate General asserted that the two sides had held direct meetings in Bahrain and abroad, and with those working for the interests of Qatar in Hezbollah, exchanged messages and held telephone conversations that had been monitored in accordance with legal procedures. He added that the contacts and meetings had shown the two sides shared a willingness to carry out hostile acts in Bahrain and harm its standing through exchanging information about the movement of the military forces entrusted with maintaining security and stability during the 2011 crisis in Bahrain, and discussed hostile acts that could be conducted to face military actions. The contacts had also revealed Qatar's attempts to weaken the military actions through refraining from participating in them and directing its media outlets to support the events unfolding in Bahrain. The suspects appeared in the Qatari media and disseminated information and news aimed at damaging Bahrain's military, political, and economic status and undermining its prestige and respect abroad. He also said that in addition to exchanging intelligence with the Qatari side, the suspects carried out hostile acts through calling for resisting and confronting the authorities using force and violence and through terrorist crimes. He affirmed that the report had proved the responsibility of the suspects in acts of violence and terrorism, as well as in funding terrorists to carry out hostile acts, adding that the defendants had received financial support from Qatar to carry out their activities aimed at harming the status and interests of the kingdom. Reports also showed that Ali Salman had tasked one of the suspects to carry out acts that would damage the country's standing and national interests and appointed another as a communication officer with Qatar. The Advocate General said numerous events, meetings, statements, and interviews conducted with the suspects on the Qatari media channels were monitored, noting that they revealed that the two sides had agreed that the suspects would transfer top secret information to the Qatari side to serve its plots against the regime by spreading chaos and instability and causing continuous internal unrest to overthrow it. The Advocate General said Ali Salman was quizzed in the presence of his lawyer and was present with evident documents of the charges leveled against him. The hashtag Freeze Qatar's membership led social media websites in the last few days after Twitter's reacted to earlier statements by Minister of Foreign Affairs Sheikh Khaled bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa that called for freezing Qatar's membership in the GCC Council. This came in response to Qatar's continuous policy of supporting terrorists and destabilizing the security of the region. The foreign minister's Sunday call on his Twitter account was widely accepted on the local and international levels, reflecting public dissatisfaction with Doha's policies in the region. It also shows the public support to the countries calling for combating terrorism and those who fund it.